believe you all will wait for some of the gum because this is very easy. It's a piece of cake. I changed the title a little bit so that you will get the temple message immediately. It's early, it's as fast as 40 minutes. So let me introduce you the phenomena we call it collinear masking. I think this is well known that there are factors affecting our attention. That according to structuralism, you will find that we try to focus something that have distinct details. If it's gestaltism, then they will think that attention will focus on something group as a whole. However, these two ideas actually are conflict to each other. Taking a look of the example from Jeremy Wolf, if you want to find something vertical, I think you will see this vertical bar immediately. However, I will tell you there are other four vertical bars. They are all hidden. You might not see them because they are well grouped in the local structure. So when something is grouped, they lose their feature contrast. So we are curious about the four. We can put this into four cells. Like feature contrast can be strong or weak, and perceptual grouping can be strong or weak. And when both of the information are weak, this is a baseline. Compared to this baseline, if the perceptual grouping is strong, then it can attract attention. If the feature contrast is strong, we know it can attract attention. However, we do not know whether it will attract attention or not when it is both information are strong. And we try to create this condition and prove that actually it masks you to look for the target. The condition is like that. We make all the display filled with the horizontal bars. And in this condition, we have one column that are all vertical bars. So in this case, this column, we call it distractor because it's not a target. It's very salient because there is a 90 degree orientation contrast. And also it's well grouped because they are all head to tail, so it's aligned to each other. So this is a well grouped and salient distractor. And we have a target that is small. It could be left heel, right heel or left heel, and on horizontal or vertical. So your task is just to tell whether in this trial is a left heel or right heel. And we have these two all overlapping accidentally, so that this distractor do not predict the target location. Of course, your first look must be here because it's so salient. However, after several trials, you know this is nothing to do with your task. You are looking for this tiny target. And in this case, we found that very strong this effect is that if you are looking for something in the background, you are faster and more accurate compared to if there is a target on a very salient collinear structure. Actually, you are delayed and less accurate. And this effect is so strong, we replicate several times. So I think this is quite amazing that so salient a place you just cannot see the target. And we have other conditions, say if it's orientation contrast that matters, then we have this orientation condition. However, there's no use. If its orientation is important because of its horizontal or vertical, then there is no use. You need to make them head to tail, collinear to each other. If it's salient, however, it's not in orientation dimension, it's luminous, brighter or darker, no use. You can still actually be facilitate, you'll see the target. And if it's collinear, but it's a very weak collinear, like it's very small, then there is facilitation. And if it's collinear, but it's not salient enough, like if it's in the background and or this area, because this horizontal condition is also collinear to each other, then they are like the baseline. And only the collinear bar in the border that can mask the target. So now we know that two factors that are important. One is that you need to have orientation dimension, high contrast, and also you need to be collinear. So these two information are very important to hide the target. And we know that the information process is hierarchical. At the very beginning, well, after the talk, Michelle gave yesterday, we know that maybe there is reverse hierarchy or something. But anyway, a small or a very simple information that is processed in extraspinal cortex, and more complex information that is in more frontal areas. And we know that the temporal characteristic can be a tool to pull to see this information process. Like this is done by Ran Qihong and Vincent Walsh. They do a conjunction search. The target is a conjunction with orientation and color. And they have a V1 area to do a double hit TMAs. And you can see that within 100 milliseconds, the performance decrease compared to there is no TMAs. However, if it's beyond 100 milliseconds, there is nothing difference. However, if it's beyond 200 milliseconds, the difference was shown again. That means that if you need to conjunct two features, then the information at the beginning was processed in V1, and then after several, say, 200 milliseconds, the information will come back to search the information on V1. So the temporal characteristic can give us some hint that where the information will process in the brain. But we don't have TMS, so I will show you behavior data today only. And no matter it's TMS, ERP, or behavior data, actually we know that from literature, within 100 millisecond patient duration, usually our brain are computing features or salient information. And if it's beyond 100 milliseconds, the information is about illusory contour, conjunction, contour integration, or figure ground segregation. Like what we said before, the collinear masking field have two information. One is salience, one is collinear. So we try to know whether the collinear masking field is happened at a very early beginning stage or later feature conjunction stage or both. So that is the goal of this study. And we have four experiments presented today. We try to create a mask in the first three experiments. And the first experiment, the mask can mask salience information and collinearity information. In experiment two, the mask is effective only for salient information. And in both experiments, we found that it's too difficult. So we have a third experiment with mask, however, it's nothing. It's just a cross on the screen. So and in the fourth experiment, we try to have our search display precede our target and to see whether the effect is still there. So the procedure with mask is like that. We have fixation display, and then the search display with the target was on. And then with only, say, 40, 70, 150, and the 300 milliseconds, and the mask will display. And then the subject respond. The response time is when the target, the search display onset until they make the response. And then the next trial will start with the interval. This is the mask we showed in the first experiment. You see, this is our search display. So we have our the collinear bar on the all the possible collinear bar location all over the display, and also the horizontal locations. So in this case, the collinearity information was masked. And also, because this collinear bar can be in everywhere, and there is nothing contrast, not if orientation contrast in this mask, so we suppose the salience and the collinearity are all masked. And the target location is always on the central location or the task will be too difficult. And we have the mask for the target as well. And with this mask, we found that overlapping or not, remember that the collinear masking phase is that overlapping is slower and more less accurate than non-overlapping condition. And you can see that this is significant in the later, if it's over 150 milliseconds, both reaction time and accuracy can see the consistent result. However, we observed that if the presentation duration is within 100 milliseconds, actually these points are approaching 50%, so it's just a guessing for the subjects. So we make the experiment to an easier mask. This mask will have all the bars, possibly horizontal or vertical. However, there is nothing grouped together, so the collinearity information was not masked. And the central location is masked for the target. So this mask supposedly can block salience information only. And with this mask, we found that the time points become earlier. At 70 millisecond duration, we can see the differences. However, these differences is nearly significant, but it's significant in accuracy data. And in this experiment, we still found that the 40 millisecond performance is nearly guessing. So we have the third experiment with minimum interference. In this condition, we just off the search display and present across at the center. And in this case, you can see all the presentation duration have this effect in both RT and accuracy. So we may make a conclusion, say the collinear masking effect can observe in very early duration.